got his lines wrong with his long irons in the last couple of holes. He missed the green from 240 with a 4-iron in his hand on the par 5, and not only took eagle out of play, but ended up walking away with par. And then on this par 3, it's a right-hand pin, and he started the ball right for some reason with a cut. I wondered why he's missed the green. So he's got to get his lines right. And this has got to be a flop, it can't be a chip. That's a good effort, a really good effort. That's better. He needed to execute that same shot on this hole yesterday and didn't do it and walked off with a bogey. Yesterday he just employed a chip and ran it 15 feet past. And you've got to have, the reason you practice the flop shot is so that you've got it in your armory. So that should be a good pass aid there. Carl's just going to tidy up for his par here after a really good little flop shot. Still trying to understand why he got his starting line so wrong on the tee though. That's two long lines in succession that he started well right.
Yep.
That's a good three, leaves him at one under for the round and in that tie for 13th. This is the hole where we went down like a pack of spuds yesterday. Spent 15 minutes on the tee box waiting for and then working with the trainer to work out what was wrong with his knee, his right leg. Don't know what the lollipop guy is doing behind him. Anyway, driver. Let's see if we can get this landing. Should be up here somewhere. Right in front of me here. So he's not in too much trouble there. Trouble was right there. Right, I'm up near the green. Karl has 160, give or take a yard. So I measured it from down there. I put an empty bottle of water next to his ball so it was easy for him to find it. And while I'm there, I pull the rangefinder out and give it a zap. So I'm about 140 yards away. Doesn't like that. He's caught the bunker short and left. That's the disadvantage of hitting from the rough. Let's focus it on Karl's ball. Anybody want poached eggs for breakfast? Right, so Karl's fortunately he's got a bit of green to work with. Just checking to see if there's any stones around his ball. He's got a chunk and run it, but fortunately he's got a fair bit of green to work with here. Run, Forrest, run. Overall, that's pretty well played. Steve Ratzenegger style to avoid having the issues with his knee that he had yesterday. Well, Karl's only been able to drive this 285 yards with the adaption that he's had to make for his knee. Left himself about similar distance to the last hole. He's gonna ask Jerry to mark his so he doesn't get accused of backstopping. If he does hit Jerry's ball, that is. Don't want to leave yourself open to any accusations. To throw it up. It's going to go back to back bogeys here. So it's going to go back to back bogeys from a good drive. He's blocked it a bit right. Is it on the green? Might be. Let's hope it is. This hole, by the way, 626 yards. So Karl's about 20 yards short of the green and about 40 yards from the hole. He's got that for birdie. It's a good shot. Karl's going to be putting for birdie. He's got about 7 feet. This should feed from the right to left. Should be about well done. So that birdie takes him back to even for the round. Well, he's just worried about his calf cramping up on him when he fully extends it. First. Choosing to finish it off. Just asking his fellow playing partners if it's okay if he does that. So 467 yards, walk off with a four is always good. So let's see if I get the yardage here before Karl hits. We've got 461 yards. And they hit over a steep bank. So hopefully I position myself about 230 yards up the fairway, so hopefully we can see Karl's ball where it lands. Well, that's gone right. So the lady up there has got it, and then it's going to have tree problems with the second shot. Well, I'm up at the green. I measured it while I was down there. I think it was 165 yards. But Karl's got tree problems. He's got this tree that you can see in line with the bridge, the smaller of the two trees in front of us, indirect. Wave his line, and his ball has sat down in the rough, so it's going to take an enormous amount of strength to get this ball up and over this tree, and then he's got to factor in trying to get it up onto the green. Could be a decisive moment in his round right here. too much. Just trying to do the impossible and ending up in compounding a mistake. Right, Karl has some work to do here if he's going to get up and down because he's 30 yards short of the green. A short arm jab. Now he's just over the back and he's got a very delicate little, I think, flop he's going to have to play. Karl needs to be thinking of all of this for his par. It's got to be a little, he can't chip it because the ball will run 6 feet past. He's got to employ the flop and let the ball feed down to the hole so that at least he can either A, sink it, or B, set himself up for a bogey. What he doesn't want to do is chip it and see it run 6 feet past because he's been missing a lot of comeback putts. Played. So he's unfortunately going to take a bogey here.